this video I'll be repairing a Dell Inspiron N5110. The problem with this one is see, with the beep code there, it's telling me that the screen is not initializing properly. And I know this for a fact because I've already repaired this laptop once before. What it is the screen connector under here has become dislodged, and it's a bit, you know, it's a bit beaten, I would say. You know, it's been thrown around by kids, you know. So it's quite common to happen. But this time, what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually I'm going to secure the connector in, probably with a bit of glue this time, in hopes that it'll be a bit of a stronger connection. It's likely to come out. This belongs to my brother and sister-in-law. Has to be some kind of gunk on the CD-ROM. I'm gonna fix that before I continue. Never picked up some light yet. Here we go. Yeah, seems to be something nasty in there. Some bit of gum. Okay. The last time I fixed this, it happened because the laptop had fell off a bunk bed with the screen wide open, and it seemed to have strained the cable. So she didn't say what happened this time, but it's the same problems. So I'll remove the battery. I'm also going to remove the memory. Touching a ground connected part in order to minimize any static while I'm handling the RAM. Okay. Okay, let's have a quick look. Now, my cousin Parker asked if I could film this for her, so which is what I'm doing and why I'm going to be putting it on the internet. So, hello Parker. You're about to see the inside of your computer. Remove the DVD burner. All in shot, yeah. Got a This is a common fault, by the way, for this model. Anyone with the same model might have similar issues. This is what causes it. I try and leave the screws on the desk in the same pattern as I take them out. Nearly done removing these screws. So I'm not missing any screws. It was a pain when you struggle to take something apart and you realise that you didn't quite remove all the screws. Okay. Let's try and get this case off. No, I remember correctly. I think I gotta remove the keyboard first. Involves pushing the little plastic tabs back. Some steps somewhere. Just sticky. Okay. Yeah, okay, so a little tiny. Flip this up. And it just slides out. There's the keyboard. Some more screws on the top here. Okay, there's that. Shots for this. Okay, there's also the ribbon cable here for the trackpad. Just gently take that out. Then there's also this one here. That's for the media board. I'm not really sure which one exactly that is, but that's out. And there's one over here, just for the power button and the LEDs. If I'm not mistaken, oh wait, there's the screw right here. Should start being able to separate. Starts to open. Just have to follow it all the way around. We don't have a spudging tool, so I have to be very careful with the screwdriver. The board with the trackpad, and this gets me access right here to the cable, which is the problem. Let's go take a closer look. There, right there. See, there's a gap. See, I did put a bit of tape on it previously, but it's not strong enough. Okay, now if I just squeeze it in, I just push it in, there we go, like so, and there it is. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get some contact cement out again. Okay, with the connector pushed back in, I prepared some contact cement. Got a nice stick to apply it. Let's have a go. I'm just going to spread it right across. So it doesn't stick to anything. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to place this bit of tape back on top. The bonding should be strong enough to hold it in place, but if it needs to be replaced for some reason, then it could be, you know, easy enough to rip it out. Yeah, some of this is like cracked. Hmm. Okay. I'm going to start putting this back together. Clickety clickety. Let's get this back in. For the trackpad connector. Now let's put these four screws back in. Keyboard back in. So first I'll get the connector in. Okay. It starts at the front. Make sure all four of those tabs come down. Side. Stuck to the top there. So the magnetic hood. Clean well. Right. Okay, now to start putting the screws back in. Start over here, this is where I finished. Now this will be safe to operate while it's drying, but it's like 20 to 10 at night, so they're not going to get it back till the morning anyway, so it'll be fully set by then. I will I'll boot it up as soon as I get all these screws back in and the memory back in. Just to triple check everything is working. items back in. The SO DIMMs or whatever they're called. Lots of dust and stuff. Okay. Gentle with it for now. Things drying. Let's have a look. Okay, I put the RAM the wrong way around. I wasn't entirely sure if I had it the right way. On the memory there, maybe that's all it is. Okay. Let's have a look. Hey, success! Just as I thought it would be. What I'm going to do now is boot it up into Windows and check that the keyboard's all working. It's something I like to do when I remove a keyboard from a computer. Okay, what I do is when I'm testing keyboard is I use the time hold thing. Quick brown fox jumps over the lazy dogs. Yep, that worked. Backspace. Actually, it should work. Unlock. Didn't check the function keys as much, but you don't really need to, but seems to be fine. Yeah. Call this one a success. Please like and subscribe for more videos, and thank you for watching.